Holy cow. We went through this whole interview, and I have not talked about Daniel Bryan.
I'm one of 8 NXT pros, and my NXT rookie is Daniel Bryan.
NXT, this new concept of a show, and I was placed with Daniel Bryan. There was no one bigger on the independent wrestling scene than Daniel Bryan. Most thought Daniel Bryan should have been my pro.
Everyone has heard of Daniel Bryan. This guy's been competing for 10 years.
The pairing of me with Miz on NXT I thought was really smart because it created a really interesting dichotomy between the two of us. And it was me, the indie wrestler, who had a ton of like indie cred, right? And him, the WWE superstar, but had no sort of wrestling credibility.
You are nothing in the WWE, and you will respect me as your mentor.
Mike took him and made him the focus of that show.
I'm a champion! I'm the bro! You're the lucky!
The show is about them. You wanted to see them.
Oof.
And see what they were gonna do.
And now teammates are going at it!
Daniel Bryan and I are complete opposites. We think completely differently.
Take my star power, my charisma, and put it into you. Get it through your thick head. Be a star.
And right away, it was just magic. And such a dynamic. I mean, from Daniel Bryan on NXT to Daniel Bryan getting fired to coming back and taking my spot at SummerSlam.
You gotta be kidding me! Daniel Bryan was the Miz's rookie in NXT!
We have a lot in common, a lot more than you think. I mean, nobody ever thought I would make it either.
You didn't make it. You have accomplished nothing in the WWE.
Daniel Bryan won his first title against me.
It's you gotta be kidding me!
United States Championship.
I think the Miz is actually crying. He's weeping like a willow. Look at him.
And we have had a rivalry ever since.
There's no gentle way to say it to me. You wrestle like a coward.
I wrestle like a coward.
And boy, did he push my nerves. And boy, did I push his nerves.
You're the one that calls me the coward, but you're the one that doesn't get in the WWE ring again. No, don't you walk away from me, Daniel. Don't you walk away.
That's just
you wouldn't be in the position that you're in right now without me pushing you to be better than the lazy hack that you were before.
Lazy
yeah,
hack?
Better
are
than being the lazy
me?
Hack that
sometimes
you were before.
Sometimes in our industry, it's really difficult to blur the lines and understand what's real, what's not real. And sometimes you kind of mix both and it creates the best stories.
I want to dedicate this win to the SmackDown Live General Manager, Daniel Bryan.
Once Daniel Bryan came back, like I was like, hoo, hoo, hoo. And they couldn't keep us away. They had to bring it together and do this match.
A rivalry nearly a decade in the making. Tonight, it all comes to a head.
And we tore the house down.
He is throwing virtually everything possible at Daniel Bryan. And Daniel Bryan still in this fight.
Daniel Bryan throwing a move and drops Miz.
Incoming.
Down goes Miz.
So, I don't like Mike, right? I don't like Miz, but I respect him. He works hard, right? And I've been really pleased with some of the matches that I've had with Miz.
Oh my God!
He just took that Daniel Bryan's move. And now Daniel Bryan rolls up Miz, looking to steal one here. He got him,
what?
He got him, he got him! Miz got him!
Is that it?
No, Daniel Bryan got Miz! Miz can't believe it! I can't believe it!
It's just a competitiveness that we both have to be at the top of our game at all times.
Mike totally respects Daniel, and Daniel totally respects Mike. It's just, they're great performers.
But the fact is, Daniel Bryan!
That rivalry.
I'm the one that makes you a star, not any of these guys.
That connection, the fact that we think so differently.
Why don't you quit and go to the bingo halls?
On so many different levels. It works.
Listen, I know I taught you a lot, but please don't steal all my stuff, okay?
Well, you didn't teach me that much.
I taught you a lot back in the NXT when you were my rookie and I was your pro. I mean, if you do remember, I gave you basically your catapult to your stardom.
Did you?
I would say so. Where was the beginning of your career in the WWE? You really believe that I wasn't the one that guided you to where you are today?